Welcome to our presentation about physically based book simulation with freeform developable surfaces. There exists a high amount of digital books which are easily accessible today on a wide variety of devices like e-readers, tablets or smartphones. Those devices have improved drastically in the last years from a hardware perspective, however, little has been changed in the digital reading experience itself, even though providing an experience closer to reading a real book might prove very useful for several reasons. Studies have shown a discrepancy in reading performance and enjoyment in favor of real books compared to digital ones and give hints that a more realistic illustration of books could improve on those issues. Furthermore, some books like art books or historic books are physically hard to access and digital variants usually don't offer the same experience. We therefore want to show how recreating such an experience could be possible in real time and a physically plausible way. While simulating cloth has been investigated a lot, simulating paper-like material in real time is a rather new field. The key property to describe such material is called developability, meaning that the material can bend at each point in only a single direction, or in other words, that the Gaussian curvature is zero at every point. There have been different approaches to model this property on meshes. For example, Tang and colleagues use spline-based constraints which closely follow the continuous description but are not obvious how to simulate in a dynamic setting. Other papers, like Schreck and colleagues, use remeshing and optimize for a local notion of developability, while yielding visually pleasant results. In case of simulating a book page, remeshing could create lasting artifacts. In our work, we decided to build on top of the work from Rabinowitsch and colleagues about static modeling freeform developable surfaces via discrete orthogonal geodesic nets. The authors suggest a simple angle constraint in a quad mesh which approximates developability in a sense that such a mesh is close to a sampled version of an analytical developable surface. We use this formulation as part of our dynamic physical simulation and show it in more detail later. Furthermore, there have been other approaches in the past to improve a similar goal. However, none of the previous works tackle real-time 3D physical simulation and a completely interactive manipulation of the book pages. We'll compare to those models in more detail later. The main idea of the model is to simplify the simulation such that only a single page has to be completely simulated, while the rest of the book simulation can be simplified. The page marked in red can be grabbed by the user and is called active page, and can change a lot during the simulation. The blue parts are called page blocks and contain the remaining pages as well as the cover and stay rather still in comparison. From a simulation perspective, we simulate a fixed number of point masses. The red ones are representing the active page and the blue ones represent the page blocks. We refer to the blue ones as midline curve. We refer to the blue ones in the middle as midline curve. We are using extruded generalized cylinders for the page blocks, which allow us to have the blue points only simulated in two dimensions. With that, the number of variables to be simulated can be drastically reduced. We model the movements of the point masses X as a system of constrained dynamics with a conservative force based on some potential energy V and some unknown forces in the direction to zero out the constraints C. We are looking for the unknowns X and lambda. Both are functions over the time. We solve the differential equation by discretizing X and lambda over time and write it in a completely implicit fashion for both the potential energy as well as the constraints. We can write a discretized version as a root-finding problem and use Newton's method for solving it at each time frame k. We use four different kinds of constraints in our model, the first one being the discrete orthogonal geodesic net or DOG constraints from Rabinowitsch and colleagues to enforce a discrete notion of developability. They state that in each inner node of the quad mesh, all four adjacent angles have to be equal to each other. Second, we enforce isometry for the midline curve to avoid stretching of the page blocks and the cover. Third, we fix the active page onto the binding. Note that depending on the reading progress, the point of fixation changes its position. Finally, to keep the book in front of the viewer, we fix it at the middle of the binding edge. Fixing it at this position also automatically rotates the book such that the page blocks are nicely visible and the attachment edge of the active page is exposed to the top. For the potential energy, we use the sum of five terms. First, we enforce a soft constraint on the isometry of the active page. Note that we do not use a hard constraint in this case, since it would lead to an over-constrained system. However, by meshing only up to the fixed size of the page, we can avoid any visual artifacts as we will show later. Second, we add a bending term for the active page as well as the 2D midline curve. For the midline curve, we use a discrete Laplacian L with edge length weights, and for the active page, we use the special dog Laplacian. To imitate glue from real books in the binding, which is holding the pages up, we minimize the angle between the normal of the binding and the first segment of the right and left page blocks. This allows us to shape the page blocks in a realistic way. Finally, to make the model interactive for the user inputs are projected on a tent function above the book, to which we minimize the position of a grabbed node in the active page. The tent function enables a horizontal swipe on the touchscreen on the screen to correspond to a curve in 3D space, similar to the natural trajectory of a user turning a real book page. To account for the perceivable raw resolution of the active page close to the binding, subdivision during meshing can be employed to imitate a high resolution page. Finally, we rendered the book in real-time using OpenGL and a physically based shader, accounting also for translucency. First, we want to compare our model to previous work. Yu-Chun Chu and colleagues interpolate between multiple pre-calculated page swipe animations using a mass spring model and present them to the user activated with a touchscreen gesture. Card and colleagues focus more on practical issues and depicting large virtual books, like performance considerations, zoom and bookmarking capabilities, and more. Hong and colleagues use a single virtual cone around which the page wraps. The page is thus by construction developable and might appear more realistic, but the models still do not allow for a realistic user interaction. Lisier Putral and colleagues compared different methods and decided for a completely 2D animation with cropped images for performance reasons. Such canned 2D animations can in fact be found in many commercial and non-commercial applications as well. Our method, in comparison, enables real-time interactive manipulation of the book pages and a realistic, fully three-dimensional book visualization. The model also allows to depict different kinds of books, such as old books or artistic books. Here we can see that using the soft isometry constraints, edges may stretch as depicted in red. However, due to the meshing, there are no visible artifacts in the final mesh. Here we demonstrate how the glue and bending energies allow for different book shapes. Our method also achieves physically plausible results. The method can also easily be extended to enable more complicated or higher level user interactions. Here, we show such an extension called finger bookmarking, as suggested from Kim and colleagues, to quickly scroll through pages while keeping the last page visible. With that, the user can quickly look up upcoming or prior passages or completely change the two main open pages. Our method achieves real-time performance even on mobile devices. While we cover many aspects of real books, we definitely do not cover all. Real books often have non-rigid cloth bindings or soft covers, while we only consider a rigid cover and a binding and rigid binding in our model. We also do not model plastic effects, which typically are visible in used books. Furthermore, the rendering might not be accurate enough for highly deteriorated books, where pages don't have the same shape anymore and also do not align. We want to conclude with our main contributions. We have shown how to dynamically simulate developable surfaces based on a static formulation from previous work. We propose a way to decompose a book into 2D and 3D components. We finally present a book reading application with intuitive user interaction. Thank you for your attention.